Kulika yomulango obo, you're very welcome to Urban Today and this is a conversation where you get your kachai. Kuwaka na kabozi, kagenda kuwanga kakuomira. We are talking about the very interesting conversation that started the week, and that is a red beret. Among many things that the UPDF gazetted in the September edition of the Gazette is the red beret. And they're saying this is exclusively going to be something that's going to be now used by the UPDF. In studio, I have Francis Harmumujisha. He's also the Honorary Secretary of the Uganda Law Society. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
How are you?
I'm very terrific. How are you?
I'm okay.
Willis, first start with his name.
Harmumugasho.
Harmumugasho.
There is purpose.
There is purpose.
Value, importance, purpose.
Hey, you're powerful all the way, man. Harmumugasho.
Okay. Let's start with the Gazette.
Yes.
There's very many people out there who don't know what this is. What is the Uganda Gazette?
The Uganda Gazette is more of a newspaper where if you want to advertise anything for exclusive use, like caveats, like all other applications, you need to gazette them. It is produced by the Uganda Publication House in Entebbe. So, for example, if you want to register a patent, you want to register a trademark, you have to put it in a gazette, advertise it in the gazette. That is, if you want it for exclusive use.
So it's not just a parliament thing or an executive wing thing, it's a Uganda thing.
Yeah, it's a Uganda.
As a citizen, I can gazette something.
Yes, you make an application and it will be gazetted.
Is it...
Like if you want to change your name also?
Yeah, I did poll. It has to be gazetted or you put in a newspaper of wide publication. But if it is to be used internationally, I would encourage that you put it in the Uganda Gazette because it is recognized internationally.
How many gazettes have we had this year alone?
Every other week there is a gazette which comes out, unless there is a reason they have not published it. But every other week there is a gazette that comes out, publishing different things. When advocates are applying to be enrolled, you have to gazette your application in the Uganda Gazette. So very many things they publish in that gazette.
Where do we find the gazette? Because the gazette it seems like a very rare commodity.
No, it's actually sold in Entebbe at the office of the publishing house, and there's another outlet of the same company opposite Christ the King. I don't know what that house is called, Airways House, on the ground floor. You'll find all laws that have been gazetted and the gazette itself. It's free, I mean, you purchase it like you purchase any other
paper. Newspaper.
Yes.
What's interesting about this particular edition that we're talking about is that the UPDF has gazetted uniforms, badges, uniforms, hats, shoes, and, you know, their attire, basically. And what is contentious about this particular gazette also is that they've gazetted the red beret. It has created a lot of conversations and whatnot. But let me start from the colors. In your legal perspective, is the red color, not just the beret, but the color in itself, is it now gazetted that if I put on a red cap, it's going to be an issue?
No. The red color is a universal color. Every human being, if you want to use it for anything, it is it's free. You are part of your freedom. It's not part of what was gazetted. What was gazetted was certain marks on a red color. The coat of arms on a red color. The UPDF logo on a red color. I know you are picking out only the red color, but if you look, there were so many different
there
colors.
There was green.
My there understanding,
was we, blue.
Since politics came into power, we've had political colors.
Yes.
Now, the political colors are colors that represent people's political ideologies and political parties. And it has always been since time immemorial that yellow is the color for the liberalism. And red is the color for the left wing.
Defiance.
Yeah, the left wing
revolution
ideologies.
Yes.
Right now, I am wondering, when they say something close to the red beret, does it mean, because it's in the fashion sense, people wear these berets in the fashion sense mostly. myself included. Yeah. Now, we have countries where it is part of their style. It's part of their traditional outfit, like the French. The yes. beret is part of their French outfit. Does it mean that right now, the Frenchman cannot get onto the plane and come here in his beret because it is a red beret?
No, that's a misconception because the red beret, if put on with any other mark, there is no problem. Legally, there is no problem. But if that Frenchman or any other citizen comes putting on a red beret with a UPDF logo or a red beret with a coat of arms, then that one is infringing on the UPDF stores, government, actually they are government stores.
There's you know, they say that if you put on something that is like,
yeah,
where do we draw
that
the line?
My problem is
something
now.
Like it now. Isn't a red beret that
likeness.
Has my face like
now that is passing off. If you the estimation is an ordinary citizen, can he easily confuse you with the UPDF officer? That is the test. Any ordinary person picked on any tax bound for Entebbe.
But for the uniform to be complete, should for that civilian to confuse me for that authority, don't I have to be wearing the entire fatigue with the red top, with the uniform that has been gazetted? I mean, if I'm wearing just like now my black dress and I'm wearing the cap, I have this feeling in me that this is the beginning of infringing on freedom of expression, because how I dress up is me expressing myself. First, it was the red clothing. We saw students getting beaten up by political people because they're wearing a red uniform.
Yes.
These children did not choose that red uniform, but here they are being beaten because they're wearing the color red. So are we supposed to tell people, get off the color red? Because what happens now? Can those students sue?
What happened for the students, I recall that incident. That was a criminal, and as I speak, I don't think he's free. He may be in some prison somewhere.
Yeah.
So we cannot justify a criminal carrying out criminality. That one would be dealt
with. Based on the color red.
Now, being based on the color red, you see, if you look at the color red and you look at criminality, that's your business.
Yes.
But the law is saying, if that color red has a coat of arms, if that color red has a logo of UPDF, you are infringing on government stores.
Okay.
If
so, right now it is the symbol, it's not the color.
The symbol imposed
on that
on that beret. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. But if it's not, if you put a Marwa Dealers Association logo,
you're not infringing.
In case I am attacked because I am wearing my Jonam girl and it's a red beret, who do I report to?
You report to police, you go to court. We have civil courts here. If somebody attacks you for putting on something you are free to put on.
What if I'm RIP and I'm all gone?
I'd like to show you a picture. One is an unfortunate incident that was in Chiseka Market. It was a demonstration years ago. And the other is a 2019 citizen expressing their rights to demonstrate. These are pictures of both. And if you can see their council, that's an army man in a red top. And this is another citizen. These are other citizens also expressing their rights to freedom here. Isn't there confusion? And that is, of course, an army general, and the other is a civilian putting on red berets. This red beret does not have, this one has the coat of arms.
Now, the
can't you confuse the two for, isn't one infringing on the others?
So if you say you can be confused, you know you are not an ordinary citizen, but if an ordinary citizen can be confused, then you will be infringing on government stores. And I wonder actually why all this time they had never gazetted them. Because
why now?
You see, the power to gazette, the power to gazette is captured under the law. We need to appreciate a civilized society that as Ugandans we aspire to live in. We send our members of parliament to come up with laws.
Yes.
And there is the UPDF Act of 2005 that was enacted by our members of parliament. Under section 161, a minister, who is a minister of defense, was empowered to gazette any symbols any symbols, any logos, if put on any building, if for example that symbol is put on this building, it automatically becomes a government building.
Yes.
So you cannot own it privately. The same applies if it's put on a vehicle, that symbol. So they ought to have gazetted it a long time ago.
So in your own opinion, do you think that there's a question of timing here that was intentional and therefore it becomes a bad sort of gazette or action? Because, you know, if the timing, the political climate, and now they come through to gazette that.
Well, that's where the confusion is coming from, and I think the minister should really come clear that this is not targeting any political group, because he ought to have done it since 2005.
Yes.
I'm curious. I am a lady,
yes,
and we like to wear everywhere with our fashion sense.
Yes.
There is the military boots that have been also banned.
Yes.
Yet we have our boots that we can put on that are somehow in the likeness of the boot, but it's for my fashion sense. So I'm wondering, if I walked into any supermarket, maybe a shop in town, and I get my leggings that are printed, they are leggings printed with the military camouflage.
Yes.
Am I abusing any rules or laws?
With or without the logo?
Without the logo, just the leggings. Military camouflage.
Does it look exactly like the camouflage that was gazetted?
Now that's another thing, because the military camouflage nyingi, zaukana. Kati, is it the camouflage nga camouflage? So are they restricted? Because camouflages are different.
See,
there are many.
They've put the gazette has a number of camouflage. You know,
very
the
minimal.
War, the home, the different departments of the UPDF has. You know, different camouflage. The police has also its own camouflage. I guess the question you're asking here is, how are they going to enforce this? Is it just talk to the citizens, or are they going to begin arresting people?
Definitely, in a civilized society I talked about that would want to have, there should be sensitization after gazette. That the following have been earmarked for exclusive usage by the people's civilized army. Now, after sensitization, that's what I would imagine, then people will get to appreciate, because there is an offense, but it's a very serious offense. The sentence is life imprisonment if you are caught putting on that particular tunic with a logo or UPDF logo or with the coat of arms. So it's a serious offense, and I would wish that the citizens first are sensitized instead of being just arrested en masse. And that's why you people in the media really need to do a good job. Not to bring out only the one red color.
The one red color, but also
the red color. Red color, if you want it for political reasons, there is the people of Uganda also have a law called the Political Parties and Other Organizations Act. And the Electoral Commission Act, if you want to use any color for purposes of political activity, even if you are an independent, it has to be approved by the Electoral Commission. And the reason is simple. Let's not cause confusion. We presume that the people in the civilized community called Uganda would want to look at you, distinguish or identify you with your ideology, with what you are going to do for them, and be able to elect you without confusion. Now there is a political party, I hope you know it, called the Uganda People's Congress.
Congress, yes.
It has exclusive usage of the red color during political activity. So if you want to use that red color for political activity, you must either be sponsored by the Uganda People's Congress or receive permission in writing from them that you are supposed to use that color, and Electoral Commission would allow
political
you.
Issues.
Yeah, political issues, political activity. But if it is for fundraising, it is for a race, you are free to have that red color.
Would you say I'm thinking too deep? Because first, it was the clothing.
Yes.
Second, it is the beret. What next is coming? Would I be wrong to say that we are tending towards oppression?
Where I do not know.
Of a certain sect of people.
Which particular sect of people? Let's be specific here.
The ones who love color red. I'm not going mostly on the political. Yeah.
Let me just ask it straight the way you're saying. She's saying that, and isn't people power going to be, you know, oppressed? In a statement coming through from Bobi Wine, Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, he says that this is meant to oppress them, to oppress you know, their ideas and their ideologies. But do you think that we're headed towards that direction? The timing of the Gazette, the colors of you know, this particular beret is headed towards sort of putting them in a corner. Is that right?
Do you know why we have laws in a country? Mm. We have laws because we want all of us to play by specific known rules. Mm. Now, if today I came and decided to enter this building without any appointment and said I have freedom of movement and being in any place in Uganda, by you stopping me from coming into your building, you are oppressing me. The law should not be, it should not be twisted to fit a certain group of people.
Okay.
For me, I'm an advocate of all of us being under the law. If you want me to comply with the law, please also comply on your side. So before we say the people power are the main target or they have been targeted, let us appreciate, are they lawfully doing what they are supposed to do? If they are not, then the law has the way it operates. The people of Uganda have the Police Act, where they established the police, and the police would invite them, for example, to ask them about the infringement, if at all it's there. But personally, I don't see any infringement. The people power belt and the one that was gazetted are totally different.
Different things.
They are totally different. They are free to enjoy their freedom in Uganda as long as they do not put the logo
of
and
the
coat of arms.
On
any Ugandan would be concerned.
Counselor, in that line, Imi, let me just cut you short for a minute. I'd like to play you a video of some of our audiences. We went out and asked this question, and you know, here are their views here in this video.
Nganzi ndoza chibi kubanga ebisele bisinga kubaka teze nkofira zifulumira mu print nyingi kati atene chiala zisoro fulumanga zagalufana ganeza amaje nenga siza amaje atene chiala emabega ka unauli ako kufira oba people power anti babu kola chibabu tongoza sokati ndabanga oboto obode dembeli abantu kubanga kiletawo obutakwatagana bulungi kuba naffe tubadde tukitegeera bulungi kubanga emabega awo twawulira nti babutongoza ate we bajja ne bagamba nti ate birimu ebyamaje biki biki kwe gaba babanga bagamba babujjewo which is not good
okusinziira nga zenga kyendaba nti abukofiira buno si kizibu naye lebe matalinga etya nti ze wenyongera wenyambala kakofiira kange nga tekaliko lebo y'amaje yona basi ziza musango azini waliwo enkofiira eziriwo ngojeko buno obuli mu type w'abamaje ng'obufulume buno nga people power bwina saawena ngojeko bo kati nze wenyambala enkofiira yange eno eya red zino eza bulijjo so nze suggestion yange eri nti ezo enkofiira as long as teriiko lebo y'amaje nze ngamba baalitulekedde eddembe lyaffe ne tubwambala yes
kati kitegeeza civilian bwabwambala oba togenda kwawula w'amaje na waki na muntu wa bulijjo kye bakoze ekyobbugaana ndaba nga kirungi olw'ensonga omuntu wa bulijjo oba talina ojja mawulirana w'amaje kuba n'abamaje babeera abeera muleeya naye ng'ataddeko katopiko kka okuggyako baagi
sikirabamu buzibu kubanga sikirabamu buzibu nti kirungi kubujjako kubanga katugeze batuwe eddembe lyaffe buli omu alina okukola kyakola ki kyayagala buli omu bali mulekedde eddembe lye n'akola ki mpozi nga bwe ba balaba nti bwe babambala mulimu ensobi gye babeera bakola ki bakoleramu naye nga weba tewaliiwo nsobi buli omu wa ddembe kukola ki kwambala obukofiira obwe n'ekirala n'amatshirt ga red kati nze mbeeranye n'ekiteteeyi kyange kya red n'entambula mu kkubo ne bagamba ate ndi wa people power ng'ate nga tisiri wa people power buli omu wa ddembe kwambala kala gy'akola ki gy'ayagala
baba batugyeko eddembe lyaffe okukola bye twagala ate nga bagamba baatuwa eddembe naye tetukyayinawo mulembe n'akamu
ebyo nze sirina kyembimanyiiko kuba nze ndi civilian sirina kyakubyogerako
All right, those are some of the sentiments of the people. I'd like to ask you, there are people, I think, 2-3 years ago when that were arrested because they were putting on camouflage. Now, this camouflage did not have the army logo or the emblem or the UPDF logo. Do they have in that, because you said that if you don't have the logo, then it's okay. So if these guys were arrested, and you know they were processed, can they claim damages?
If you are prosecuted without any crime being committed, you can sue government for unlawful prosecution and you'll be compensated heavily. Now, one thing I've gathered from the views expressed by the citizens, there's something we need to appreciate. If you want to learn, you may need to unlearn what you already know. Now the position is, for you to be against the law, you have to be found with a red beret, the logo, or coat of arms. Now, if you are talking from a viewpoint of anything
red.
Now you just need to say, okay, I may be wrong. They may appreciate this is what has been gazetted, not general sentiment. And you see, let's not popularize this. Appreciate that Uganda has over 40 million people, and possibly People Power has 5 million people. But those 40 million people have a force they call UPDF. They have a force they call police. If I'm in trouble, I want to easily identify. I pay heavily in taxes for that police officer or military officer to easily be identified by me. So imagine it was, we all want to enjoy our freedoms. Imagine we woke up and say, okay, everyone, you are free to put on your police uniform. One criminal-minded person will stand by the roadside and stop cars before you realize we do not know who is a police officer
and who is not. A citizen.
So whereas we would want to enjoy our freedom as 5 million people or 2 million people. Remember, there are 40 million people. And they want to enjoy the freedom of being able to identify a police officer, being able to identify a UPDF officer. So when we have rights, let's not presume that we are the only ones who have rights.
But everyone in Uganda
has rights.
I'm now interested in a direct answer from you.
Yes.
Who owns the red beret?
Who owns the red beret? Nobody owns the red beret.
But if it has the symbol,
UPDF or a coat of arms, now that is defined as government stores. It is part of government stores.
But if it has no symbol,
it doesn't have any symbol.
The government, I am
nobody
safe.
Owns it.
Okay, am I safe in my red beret? Am I safe?
In a civilized society called Uganda, you are safe.
Okay, now in situations where I'm being arrested, what process, what is the legal way of arresting a person?
Arresting a person, one, the arresting officer should identify himself and inform you of the offense that you are being arrested for.
I'm so
should be taken to a gazetted press. Gazetted presses, as of now, we have police stations. And if you are found that what you are doing has elements of crime, you are supposed within 48 hours and not any second after, you are supposed to be taken to court. If court is a...
I'm not allowed a phone call before that?
No, you have freedoms. You are supposed to access your relatives. If you want a lawyer to be represented by a lawyer, you demand for that right.
Is there a state lawyer I can ask for?
Unfortunately, the legal aid bill has not passed. Our members of parliament are serious doing other things. but if they had passed the legal aid bill, then everyone in Uganda would be entitled free legal representation if you can't afford it.
So we have a legal aid bill which
it is in Parliament that we have had very many promises that it is going to be passed, but they are busy doing very many other things except passing laws like the legal aid bill.
Mr. Harimo Mugisha, thank you very much for coming through to the Urban Today Show. But just as we sign out, what's with the Uganda Law Society? What are you doing? What's happening there? You have there's a week that you're celebrating recently. I think you were in Arua.
Yes.
Or Gulu.
We have a Rule of Law Week.
Yes.
Very many activities that are lined up for to sensitize people about the rule of law. And what we aspire to have is the law above and everyone, including the generals, including the richest men in town, including the poor, including the opposition, should ascribe to that. That's when we can enjoy a civilized society where we are all peaceful. We are not pro-government, neither are we pro-opposition. For us, we are pro the law. If the opposition is against the law, we shall tell you, man, if you want the law changed, go to Parliament. The law is against the government. You've seen us.
Yes.
We make statements to communicate because the Uganda Law Society is created by an act of parliament to advise government. So for us, we advise. There are people we advised previously and they refused. You know what happened to them.
We also ask guys to pass that bill because we need that bill.
We are following. Then when we get an opportunity like this, we tell the members of parliament,
yes,
do what took you to parliament. Please pass the legal aid bill.
Yes.
People need
legal representation.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much, Francis Harimo Mugisha. You're also the secretary of the Uganda Law Society. I hope to engage you sometime, I think later, to also talk about other legal things, as of which, the climate, the political climate is getting heavy and the conversations are going to be tricky. But that's what we had for Kachai today. The Red Beret conversation is still going on until next week, until probably next week. I hope you've learned a thing or two now. We head over to a short break. When we get back, we shall be in the love letter and someone needs our help.